I don't, you know, I always hold myself to a very high standard. Hold myself to a very high standard in everything that I do, and I think obviously I try and control the things that I can, and you know, I touch the ball every play, so I obviously want to protect it, but you know, it did hurt us. It hurt us. You know, you never know what play it would be, but it hurt us. You look back and you want to reflect on the things. Maybe you could have done something more. Maybe you could have to change the outcome of the game. And you know, that's the way it was.
Jalen Brown, Patrick Mahomes said that you had an outstanding performance for a guy the first time on the stage and everything. Can you take any solace from that? Even with the fumble, you know, can you take any solace from that, from what he said?
I have a lot of respect for him. I have a lot of respect for him. I always have. He's done some really great things this far. I think for me, you know, we lost. We came at a win. Came up short. So, you know, it's something that I know that'll motivate me. I've been here before. That's the beautiful thing about it. So, I'll figure it out.
John, we know that you typically don't show a lot of emotion. Can you describe your emotion?
You either win or you lose. You either win or you learn. That's how I feel. You either win or you learn. So, you know, as always, win, lose, or draw. I always reflect on the things that I could have done better, things we could have done better to try and take that next step, and that'll be the same process that goes on now.
What'd you learn?
And watch the film yet.
Jalen, I know it's wrong, but what do you want to take from
that you addressed the team and tried to apologize.
You know, I don't do this to be loved. I don't do this to be hated. I don't do this to seek anyone else's approval. I do it for the guys in the locker room. I do it for all the time that we've invested into this. Do it for the love and the thrill of growing. That's something we put the work in, and you go out there and get it. You know, you go out there and you make it happen. And you know, it is a tough feeling to come up short. You know, it's a very tough feeling. But I know that the only direction is to rise, and you know, that'll be the MO going forward. That'll be the mentality going forward. That is the mentality. Obviously, credit them for the game that they played, and a very competitive football game, and a competitive football team, and Coach Reed. But, you know, we'll sit back and we'll reflect on it, and we'll learn from it.
Star tight end Travis Kelce, the
man of the people.
Yeah.
And here is the commissioner.
Ninth pick to the Philadelphia Eagles. With the ninth pick in the 2023 NFL draft, the Philadelphia Eagles select Jalen Carter, defensive tackle, Georgia.
And there it is.
He's got a block in there.
Well, if that's the case, he might need another one, yeah. And maybe something stronger before it's all over. There is Jalen Carter, wildly talented defensive lineman from Georgia. There certainly were some issues off the field. He was involved in a misdemeanor charge of reckless driver racing in connection with a crash that killed a teammate and another University of Georgia staffer. He's from Apopka, Florida, which produced Hall of Fame defensive tackle Warren Sapp. So now another great defensive lineman out of that hotbed of football players. Jalen Carter on his way to Philadelphia. Here are some of the issues that I alluded to in mid-January, right after Georgia had celebrated its national championship. He was present at the scene. The crash had killed a couple of people. He left the combine to turn himself in, ended up pleading no contest to those misdemeanor charges that I referred to, then later showed up a little bit heavier. He's a big man anyway, but a little bit heavier for the pro day. People raised some eyebrows about that, but you see the emotion, because certainly this has been a difficult time for Jalen Carter as he has navigated through the off-the-field troubles to see how it would impact him personally and professionally.
You can make a very strong argument. Back-to-back national champions in college football, as good a defense as we saw 2 years ago, that he's the best player on, physically the best player on that defense over the last couple years. And when he decides to turn it on, he turns it on. Philly makes that move to pick him up. You look at their depth, this defensive line is dominant. The only thing is Fletcher Cox coming up in his 12th year, he's 32 years old. Wouldn't that be a perfect fit to put him in that defensive line with Jordan Davis, who they had last year? Brandon Graham has some age on him, Josh Sweat, and now you throw this guy in the middle of that. The good get better with Jalen Carter. Now they just got to make sure he's dialed in.
And Jordan Davis, as you mentioned, a structure around him really helps him. Jordan Davis, somebody he knows well, as a teammate at Georgia.
Yeah, and Nakobe Dean, one of the leaders of the defense as well, who's a third-round pick last year. So obviously Philly's done their work and they're comfortable with him. On tape, guys, he's the best player in this draft. Yeah. There's no one who can take over a game like him. And I'm talking about the quarterbacks, the running back, doesn't matter.
With you.
He is the best player on the field. The problem is, what do you get in the other 6 days? And I hope for Jalen Carter, you know, actions have consequences, right? The consequence here was that he dropped about 6 or 7 spots and probably lost $4 or $5 million over the next 5 years, right? But I hope this is a wake-up call for Jalen, because he can be as great as he wants to be. He's got to learn to be a self-starter. He's got to accept better coaching more frequently and openly. And he's just got to be more committed, because it would be an unbelievable waste to see all of his talent if he doesn't turn out to be one of the best to do it at defensive tackle.
In the 2023 NFL Draft, the Philadelphia Eagles select Nolan Smith, linebacker, Georgia. Go Birds!
The back-to-back national champions in college football, and the Eagles are getting into that defense and bringing it to the NFL.
It's been
Jalen Carter earlier, and now no one's
Jordan Davis.
But two last year.
Jordan Davis.
You know what? I'm gonna give some credit here. Drew Gallagher on April 6th, one of our producers, texted me and said, find out who's in charge of the southeast area scout for Philly, because I got a feeling they could take one of these Georgia guys. Now they've taken 4 in 2 years, and I've got the name for you. I had to hunt it down, but it's Phil Baez, the southeast scout for the Philadelphia Eagles, and he deserves a couple meals on the team for what he's done the last couple of years.
That was the Kobe Dean that was here to be a part of his celebration that he just gave love to.
There,
Kobe Dean's already in Philly.
Bulldogs to Birds, and now Nolan Smith, the pass rusher who's injured last year but still, he's an old school mentality tough kind of guy.
Yeah. If you think Hassan Reddick is quick, this one's a 4.39.
No, it's ridiculous.
4.39, for those of you that watch Grey's Anatomy, that's really, really, really fast off the edge. He's undersized, but everything that you would want in a player from an intangible standpoint, this guy brings to the table. A motor, demands it from his teammates. He will fit in perfectly to the mentality of what the Philadelphia Eagles are all about.
Yeah, and they had 4 pass rushers with 10-plus sacks last year. Now they add that speed?
Yeah. Guys, you win in the NFL at the line of scrimmage, and the great teams continue to just get stronger. The 49ers, the Eagles.
Eagles, yeah. The Chiefs. Like, great teams are great up front.
He plays with an edge because he said he's been doubted all his life. He said, my style is aggressive. I play with a lot of energy. That's what's going to bring to the Eagles defense.
Oh,
well, since he already knows pretty much all of his Eagles teammates, because it's pretty much all of his Georgia guys that are up there right now, he's a player you're going to want to get to know and maybe cast his net a little wider in getting to know people. Smith going to the NFC Championship, Super Bowl runner-up, Philadelphia Eagles. There's one pick.
Philadelphia's latest pick, and there are, you know, some really good players that are out there from Georgia for them to have, and this would be wild if they did it again.
Please welcome NFL Senior Vice President of Football Operations and Chief Football Administrative Officer Don Aponte.
With the 105th pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Philadelphia Eagles select Keely Ringo, defensive back, Georgia.
Really going to personally... By the way, congratulations to this young man.
That's awesome.
He is now joining Nolan Smith and Jalen Carter and Jordan Davis and Nicole Dean. I am personally going to go to Philadelphia and plant the hedges.
Why not?
The stadium.
This is
that'll be a good day.
Unbelievable. Hey, if you're going to collect players from certain programs, Georgia and Alabama are probably a pretty good place to invest. But good for Keely Ringo. He was my 47th overall player. So to get him at this point in the draft at pick 105, I thought it was a tremendous, tremendous value. The size and the speed, we talked about that. It's legit track speed. The stiffness was the knock on him. But the word on that screen that I think you need to focus on is the toughness. This guy's competitive. He's tough. And when he's in phase and position, he can really play the football down the field. And I think that's why you've seen some people talk about him as potentially moving to safety. Press man, he's physical. Here he is working against Tillman, who we saw get drafted yesterday out of Tennessee, able to locate the football and really physical as a tackler. The attention on getting the football out there, CD. You can blitz him. Again, I just coming back to toughness. This is a tough kid.
And remember, this is...
Yeah, let's get, first of all, here, Charles, just a second. This is time for Next Gen Stats powered by AWS. You see the overall draft scores. When you factor everything in, look at those Georgia DBs. They've had quite a few that were not only good players, but unbelievable athletes.
Absolutely. And when you think about Keely Ringo going to Philadelphia, James Bradbury re-signed, right? Darius Slay re-signed. Surprised a little bit there. But where's the depth behind them? So I think Ringo stays at corner, Peter, to start off things and gives them that depth.
Eagles have no quarterback questions. Jalen Hurts led them to the Super Bowl this past year, and so far this offseason, the Eagles seem to have gotten even better. During the draft, they swung a trade with Detroit to add DeAndre Swift to their running back room, and Swift got to meet the Philly media today.
I'm excited. I'm happy. I'm grateful for the opportunity to be a part of a great organization with tremendous history, a team that's connected. I can just by being in the building these couple of days, that together, love each other. So I'm excited to build a relationship with the guys in the locker room and just be a piece to the puzzle. I'm so focused on just coming in here and just working every single day, just earning my keep. Whatever role they see fit for me, off of the way that I come in and work every day, will be something that I earn.
Eagles were dominant on the ground last year en route to their NFC title. They ranked second in run block win rate and third in rushing yards before contact. This offseason, they've added two running backs who know how to find room to run. Swift and Rashad Penny ranked top 10 in yards per rush among running backs last season, among backs with at least 50 carries, that is. The key for both players has been staying healthy, obviously, so now they got both of them, so I guess they're hedging their bets. Adam, how are the Eagles so able to revamp their running back room so quickly?
Well, Dan, I don't think they went into free agency or the draft thinking that they were going to target Rashad Penny or DeAndre Swift, but the way events played out made it such that in the end, the Eagles lost Miles Sanders to the Carolina Panthers when they gave him $13 million in guaranteed money, and together this season, the Eagles are paying DeAndre Swift and Rashad Penny a combined close to $3 million.
Yeah.
So for those two backs, they're essentially paying more than $10 million guaranteed less than they would have had to pay Miles Sanders. And if they can get one or both of those backs, Penny and Swift, to stay healthy, then they've hit a home run there right now, because both are enormously gifted. Both are enormously talented, and they're looking for ways to supplement that offense on an offense that's loaded with playmakers. And DeAndre Swift is in the last year of his deal, too. So he's playing for a contract in front of his hometown fans. So it should be a great fit for DeAndre Swift and the Philadelphia Eagles. Of course, it goes back to the question if both backs can stay healthy.
Yeah, and that's the big thing. If both backs can stay healthy, we also have to remember what Miles Sanders was for the Philadelphia Eagles. This was a guy that if he got a crease, he could give you the big run because he was explosive once he got into the open field. But he was also a dude that had some physicality. And so now you do need a Rashard Penny and a DeAndre Swift to kind of supplement those things, because when we saw DeAndre in Detroit, he was also paired with Jamal Williams, who was more the power back. DeAndre would get you 5 yards a touch when he rushed the football, over 40 catches. And Rashard Penny, who's a former first-round draft pick by the Seattle Seahawks, is a dude who we've seen be explosive but not always be available. And so the Philadelphia Eagles are trying to find ways to piece together this roster now that their quarterback is one of the highest paid football players in the entire history of the NFL. These are two great pieces, and if you get these guys healthy, you have really hit it big, and it seems like Howie Roseman just can't miss right now.
Real quick, I do want to make a quick point on the backs that I do think matters in relation to Jalen Hurts. We got to remember, Jalen Hurts and Miles Sanders spent 2 years together, and this is an offense that is very zone read dominant. So that mesh, when I'm a quarterback and I put that ball into belly of the back and he's got to feel if I'm giving it or pulling it, that's going to take some time with players like Penny and Swift. So as much as we talk about like quarterback timing with their receivers, in this offense, that's going to take some time for them to build that communication that often is about feel and nonverbal.
Bringing back Slay, Bradberry, the reloaded this roster.
Oh, man, it was great. I saw that thing. I said, ooh, it's Tip. Yes, sir. Let me go get that. And, of course, when I saw the green grass, I knew I was going to go get in that end zone for sure. Got the speed of Speedy Gonzalez.
Were you surprised that Mac Jones didn't really seem to give too much of an effort to bring you down on that play? Were you surprised at all by that?
Well, he did. He tried to cut me off. I just cut back on him, you know. So quarterbacks don't really too much practice in tackling. So he tried to make a tackle. I made a play, cut back, and scored. But he always give effort. I've been seeing that on film. Every time he throw a pick, got dude run down and give effort. So he's a hell of a player. He had a great game today, man. Besides that one play, he missed some throws, but he was on the point today.
From his days playing college football at Georgia to his first stop in the NFL with the Detroit Lions, Ayanna secretly knew her son would one day come home and play for the Eagles, the team her late father Henry used to watch with DeAndre.
DeAndre carries him close to him. I did not notice this until a championship they won with St. Joe's Prep. And I noticed it when I went on the field to hug DeAndre, that he wrote on his tape, R.I.P. Pop-Pop. He says, I do it all the time, and I never knew that.
For this family, football is more than a sport. Although his grandfather passed in 2005, Swift's dad, another important man in his life, was right there when he received the call that he'd be suiting up for his hometown team.
Everything kind of like fell in place, and you're like, wow, God, thank you.
Again, Swift, first down, and a lot more.
Got you. Look what you've done. Look what you've done. Look what you've done for me. You knew that I was gonna be some. We stressed out, you need some. I got you.
Shout out to my teammates blocking downfield. You know, shout out to KP and Nick. You know, caught him in the right defense, right, the right time. It's been like marinating all game, and was hoping that we can catch him into it. And I just got the ball, and my teammates showed up for me. You know, so.
And the second one, you and Forbes, I guess, were going at it pretty much the whole game. You get the touchdown on it, you let him have it.
Yeah, so, you know, he's a good player. He's growing, and, you know, it was a lot of competition out there. You know, emotion was high, you know, and I expected it, you know, and, you know, I want that. And, you know, I made a good play. Jalen gave me a check. I made a good play, but, you know, I got to be better. You know, I'm a vet now. You know, I can't do stuff like that, you know. Put the ball in front of him, so it was unnecessary. It kind of cost us some yardage on the kickoff, so, you know, I got to be better than that, you know.
At what point after that penalty did you realize, all right, I screwed up there?
Jalen kind of brought it to my attention, you know, and he told me on the sideline he can't do that. And so he was just holding me accountable at the moment. I think that's the time I kind of realized and told me, you know, the kickoff return, they had some good yards. And, you know, like I said, I can't do that regardless of my emotions high or whatever. Like, I need to go celebrate with my teammates, you know, because that's what it's about. It's never about the opponent, you know, so.
Push here in the center with everybody, or we can move it to the outside and I'll just do it.
Here's the deep ball. Got hit as he let it go. Oh, Devontae Smith. What a catch.
That's outstanding, going up and making that catch.
The Eagles have the best O-line in the game. So, yes, it's a cheat code. They're unstoppable at it. They have the best O-line, and they have a quarterback who's squatting 600, and he knows how to move his legs. We just have to deal with it. We have to adjust. We have to prepare to stop it. And it's not up to the league to say, hey, just because you can't stop it, we have to take it away. No, we have to get better. We have to get stronger up front, and we have to stop it. We have to get them out of it. Like, I don't want to be a part of a league that's like, hey, I can't stop something. I'm not strong enough. I'm not good enough to beat it. So we got to take it out the game. No.
Because you had a bad day, you take it one down, you sing a sad song just to turn it around. You say you don't know, you tell me don't lie, you work at a smile and you go for a ride.
The Eagles signed wide receiver Julio Jones to a one-year deal today.
It's an amazing place. The people here, the fans here, everything. Like last night, I think it was a soccer game going on, a hockey game going on, a baseball game going on. It was packed. Like you couldn't even. I stay like 7 minutes from here now. It took like 20, 30 minutes just to go like a mile and a half down the road. Like it was crazy. So I mean, Philly does a great job with their fan base coming out and supporting, you know, their ball clubs and their sports.
How much do you feel like you have left?
Have left? Well, just keep watching. You know, I ain't gonna make no expectations. Just keep watching, and I can show you. We'll revisit this question.
Yeah, Adam, as you're saying this, the boys up here are saying, this man don't stop. I'm assuming you're talking about Howie Roseman. RC, yeah. How big a deal is this for that Eagles secondary?
I mean, when you look at what Suge Knight, I mean, Howie Roseman has been doing in acquiring talented players for this team. He's one of the best in the world. And now you get Kevin Byard, an all-pro, Pro Bowl caliber safety who still has a lot left in the tank. And they need someone that can create ball disruptions on the back end. They had Brown and Edmonds playing the safety position. Blankenship was hurt in the last game. Now they take such a step up at that position, adding a player that was much like C.J. Gardner-Johnson, who they lost to the Detroit Lions. This is a huge move for a team that needed help at that position.
Julio, 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 Julio Jones. I'm from Atlanta, he throw me the ball and I score in his zone. They hit me up for a deal like it's something I do on the phone. Just cause it's me in the studio, don't mean I do it alone. Miracle in the middle.
Put it up to the top now. I'm on a new level. I'm on it, I'm on it. I'm on a new level. I'm on it, I'm on it. I'm on a new level. I'm on it, I'm on it. I'm on a new level. I'm on it. I'm on a new level. Put these niggas in the dirt. Chain with the new vest. I'm on a new level.
The Philly like special. This in a matter of time I spent on some locked up shit in the back of the paddy wagon, cuffs locked on wrist. See my dreams unfold, nightmares come true. It was time to marry the game, and I said, yeah, I do. If you want it, you gotta see it.
This is definitely a great accomplishment because I played with David Akers, and you know I know how good of a dude he is, and it was, you know, for me to do that. It's I ain't no kicker, but boy, it's good to be, you know, a part of that conversation.
Cause millionaires, it ain't just one. Have a few chains on, I don't have a one. Bought a few houses and I never sleep at one. And I can have 10 cars and I went drive one. And when you make it from the bottom, you the chosen one.
So the Eagles gonna get it right back as Brooks hits it. Not a very good punt, and Deshaun Jackson with a chance. Penalty flag comes in. A flag is down, and so is Jackson down the sideline and into the end zone. But a flag is down.
Therefore, there is
So they pick up the flag, and it was called against number 50 of the kicking team. That would be 50 of the Redskins, Kari Campbell.
So DeSean Jackson is back to receive Jason Baker's punt. And it's a beauty. Jackson on the 15, straight ahead. DeSean Jackson, I do not see a flag on the field. And he'll go in for the touchdown. 85 yards.
This was one of his specialties coming out of Cal, and the lane opened so big early. And then once he got into one-on-one situation with a one-on-one situation with a tackler, it's over. Right here, Sheldon Brown does a great job not clipping. All right, a good job by not throwing that block.
DeSean Jackson averaging almost 16 yards of return and leading the league in punt return average. And this is Spiegel's kick off the side of his foot, fielded at the 29. And Jackson, after circling back, comes down the sideline, and Fiegels can't knock him out of bounds, and he will go all the way for a touchdown. So the league leader in punt return average, and what a run back. As he starts from the inside, he gets pinned on a boot off the side of Fiegels' foot, and he runs it back 72 yards.
And was really in perfect position right down the sideline to contain it, but then he got trapped back inside, so when DeSean Jackson folded back around, that perfect position was gone. Man, what an unbelievable player this young man is. I mean, he is just so electric with his hands on the football. So many plays over 50 yards already this season.
First down at the 40. Great protection. And McNabb's going to go deep again and has a man. And it's Jackson who will backpedal into the end zone for a 60-yard touchdown. This is like a street game. Again, DeSean Jackson. Two long touchdowns tonight. One on a punt return. One on a pass reception.
First play from about the 12, and there is Vic, as you talked about, John, rolling and launching downfield for DeSean Jackson, who accelerates, caught the opening play, and all the way for a touchdown. 88 yards.
Wow.
It's going to be a bootleg, and they're going to full protect Vic's throwing side. He has plenty of time to set his feet and launch it. And that is at warp speed, DeSean Jackson. If he's not the fastest guy in the NFL, he's one of the fastest. But you better get your hands on him, D'Angelo Hall, and not ever let him get up against the Landry one-on-one, or it's over.
Beautifully designed by Andy Reid. You saw Clay Harbor, the tight end. They like to use that maximum.
From the 9-yard line, first down. Vic. Back to pass. And that is caught by Jackson along the sideline. And Jackson down the middle of the field being chased inside the 20, inside the 10, and into the end zone backwards for the touchdown. Wow.
Mike Vick is going to thread this one in perfectly. I mean, Jenkins couldn't have missed that by more than an inch. And then it was over. I mean, you could just see this. Jenkins just missing, and there's no support. They're up there in quarters coverage, and here it was. Could not get his hand on it, and then nobody's catching him from here. The Washington Redskins will tell you that. There's no way to catch him once he gets out there.
And DeSean Jackson, who has averaged 14th best in the NFL, 8.7 yards per return, has not returned one for a touchdown this year. Waits. And it's a line drive kick. Jackson bobbles it and now has to try and recover. DeSean Jackson gets a block. Are you kidding? DeSean Jackson still not in and now in for the touchdown. No flags. Unbelievable. No time left. Eagles win.
It's a 65-yard return. It was an awful punt. A line drive. Jackson bobbled it and then let blocks get set up. Picked his way through the Giants, got a block late, and then took it up the goal line before going into the end zone. There's no time remaining. And with that stunning ending, the Philadelphia Eagles come all the way back and are going to win this game.
Third and 10. It's only a three-man rush. Still pressure. Wentz just going to air it out. Going way deep down the field. He's got a touchdown! DeSean Jackson!
DeSean Jackson on a deep route. He's different than other receivers, and this is what I mean. With a lot of receivers, you're trying to get them to fade to the sideline. You're trying to keep the ball away from the DB. With DeSean Jackson, you throw it upfield as far as you can. He's going to eventually outrun the DB.
On third down, four-man rush. Pressure comes. Wentz going to let it fly. He's got Jackson again. He's got it. Touchdown.
He knows he's got Jackson right there. But he comes back left to freeze the safety and take him that way. And then he comes back right for the payoff to DeSean Jackson. That's what you call holding the safety with your eyes in your head.
The New York Giants rooting for Carolina and Dallas following their loss in Baltimore. Hurts on first down, fires downfield. It's DeSean Jackson back in the lineup. Missed the last seven games, and he will take it 81 yards. A somersault into the end zone. His first touchdown of the season.
DeSean Jackson, you know, has always been deceptive. He's always been deceptive with his speed, and he is literally just pulling away from Chinobe Awuzie, and there's no one that's going to catch him. I mean, he needs to trademark this.
I love it.
I love the flip.
Last game, you said you didn't know quite how to feel. After this one, where are your feelings? Where do you go from that game?
When, you know, find ways to win. That's always the mentality. That's always the approach, you know, and I think this is a moment where you go back and you reflect on it, you learn from it, like every win, and, you know, you treat them all the same, you know, when you win or when you lose. It's about what can I learn from this? So, you know, the process remains the same in terms of how we respond and how we approach it. Just have to be self-critical, as we always are. And analyze everything as it's supposed to be and respond. It's not a matter of winning or losing. It's just about playing to the standard, and we didn't play to the standard. Typically, when you play to the standard, you win. And I don't think we played to the standard and won yet, you know. We didn't play to the standard, and today we lost. So it's a great team we played, and we have to go back and reflect on it, learn from it, watch the film, and grow.